It's not a rotating camera. So secondly, the chances of being broken almost immediately. Third, nobody is going to stand in front of it. Itni bheed hai. The kind of molestation that happens is touching, chua-chut hota hai auto ke saath. Na camera usko pick up kar sakta hai, na kuch. So it's just a waste of money. This is not my money. It's the nation's money. I should spend it where it affects women the most. So while I agree that women are constantly molested when there's a crowd or a bheed in a bus, there is nothing that a CCTV camera can do to either assist or to prevent or to even frighten. These are the three reasons why it should be there. And we already did a pilot to see whether it would work. I did it in some Rajasthan buses and it simply had the shunya effect, shunya.
Menaka Gandhi, viewers, is the Union Minister of Women and Child Development of India. And she's responsible for deciding how we spend the 3,100 crore rupees in the Nirbhaya Fund, which is meant to be spent for the safety of women. She's also this person we're questioning today because she believes, as she's told us, that CCTV cameras in buses would be a waste of money. She's also turned down a request from the Delhi government to install CCTVs in buses in Delhi for using the Nirbhaya Fund. Now, Ms. Gandhi seems to be missing some very basic facts. Fact number one, the Nirbhaya Fund was set up after the horrific rape took place in Delhi in a moving bus. Fact number two, there are rising reports of inappropriate behavior, threatening behavior in buses every passing day. Fact number three, a CCTV camera acts as a deterrent for perverts and criminals. And fact number four, the CCTV camera's visuals are admissible in court as evidence and very often help the police identify the culprit. Now, what's appalling is the justification that Ms. Menaka Gandhi gives her defense in defense of her stance. And here are her reasons. Her reason one, the camera is fixed and not a rotating camera. Madam, technological advances allow us today to buy cameras that are not static. And if placed at the right place inside a bus, it can cover the entire bus. Why don't you Google it? Her reason number two, or I'm going to switch it to calling it excuse number two, is that the chances are that the camera will be broken in a couple of days. We also know that the government of Delhi had acquired vandal-proof cameras for this very purpose and they cannot be broken in a couple of days. Again, Ms. Gandhi, technology, Google it. Excuse number three, nobody is going to stand in front of a camera and molest or rape someone. Well, in this point, I agree with you, but really, contrary to what you might think, Ms. Gandhi, the aim here is not to actually get gross visuals of somebody molesting somebody else or any sort of crime in progress. The aim is to get a record of everyone who gets on the bus and off the bus so that the police and the victim can identify the perpetrator. And that a CCTV camera can do. Excuse number four, a CCTV camera is a waste of money. A waste of people's money. Now, I am so glad that she is being prudent about how we spend the people's money. Let's also hope she applies this prudence and the ideas of frugality that she has brought into these CCTV cameras to the government's projects of statues, the government spends on advertising and marketing, and perhaps how much we're spending on Yoga Day. But here's the question. Why does the Delhi government need the permission of the Women and Child Ministry of the central government to install CCTV cameras in its own buses? And the answer is simple. The Delhi government is seeking to use money from the Nirbhaya Fund for this project. Now, using the Nirbhaya Fund requires the nod of both this ministry and the Home Ministry. The Delhi government needs 140 crore rupees to install these cameras. The Delhi government has an expenditure of 53,000 crore rupees for this year. For example, it's currently doing 175 crore rupees to install CCTV cameras in government schools. How difficult would it be, Mr. Sisodia and Mr. Kejriwal, to take the extra 140 crore rupees from your own budget if you were really serious about the safety for women? What's happening now? The Delhi government is passing the buck to the central government. The central government is passing the buck back to the Delhi government. Who's left without CCTV cameras? You and me. Petty politics, at the end of the day, is staying and standing in the way of safety for women. Kejriwal could have put in those CCTV cameras without help from the central ministry, but he went and asked anyway. Menaka Gandhi said no for reasons that completely befuddled me today. And neither of them have offered any alternate solutions. If Menaka Gandhi's ministry was convinced that CCTV cameras were such a colossal waste of money, what is your other solution? You're obviously acknowledging that molestation happens, that all of these bad, horrible things happen on buses. What is your other solution? The truth is you don't have one. And as always, the safety of women pushed to the back of the bus, this time quite literally. This is the question we are asking. Should we put CCTV cameras in buses? And the reason why this is important, because it's not a Delhi problem, it is a nationwide problem. And when Menaka Gandhi makes that decision, she makes it for the whole country and not just for Delhi. Joining me on the show today.